I saw an email earlier on today which blessed me. You know, sometimes when we pray, we don't understand what we're doing. We don't really understand sometimes. And I saw an email today that blessed me, and I'm hoping that, you know, I'll be able to get, you know, this person to testify, you know, about the prayer that we pray. And, you know, this young man turning up to work, and that principality. You see, a lot of times what we don't understand is that there are principalities, and, you know, they do exist. Because, you know, I quoted something earlier on today, you know, where I believe when it was time for Jacob to bless his sons before he departed, you know, after Jacob, you know, had stolen the birthright from Esau, it was quite strange that when he was getting ready to pronounce the blessing upon the lives of, you know, Esau, once he recognized that Jacob had tricked and stolen the birthright from Esau, what he said was quite unique. He said a lot of things to him, but then he said to Esau, basically, on the day that you become restless, imagine, he said, on the day that you become restless, when you begin to understand that what happened to you was not normal, when you begin to realize that what the enemy did to you, or what the enemy has done to you, is not normal. The day you begin to see that, that's the day that you'll be able to break that yoke off you. Listen to me. Some of you are sitting down, waiting. You've become part of what I call church jargon. If it's in God's will, if God, listen, God has given us dominion. God has given us power. God has given us the ability to make decisions on this earth, as long as we are within his will. If we are in his will and we invite him in, then there is nothing that will prevent God from coming in. And so sometimes in our quest to be weak, in our quest to, you know, just kind of like, oh God, you know, if God, you know, if it's God's will. No, God has given us the power, and we have to exercise it. Amen. Listen, if there's anybody on here who this is your first time, I'm challenging you to make the commitment for this week. There are many testimonies. There are many things happening. Even for me personally, there are some amazing things which are happening. You know, and I challenge you. Listen to me. God is not through with none of us yet. God is faithful. God is committed to us, and we need to show the same commitment to him. Nothing is going to separate us from what God has for us. This morning over on this side, you know, London, and this evening for you guys over there in the States, I want you to know that the heavenly records has opened up. There is going to be a record today of every prayer that you pray. There is going to be a recording. See, listen to me. Just like, see, whenever we, see, sometimes on this earth, we catch up to what heaven, you know, has always had. You know, with conference calls and stuff like that, it was never really there. You know, it only kind of like, you know, over the last couple of years, we've got this conference call. Listen to me. When I was a little bit younger, my friends would tell you, I used to record all my prayers. And they will ask me why. And I said, listen, I record it and play it back so that I will remember the things that I was asking God. See, when you take, or when you make an investment and you really decide to test God, not to test God, but when you decide that, you know what, God, I'm going to make sure that I don't let you go. Listen to me. Jacob wrestled with an angel. And when the time came and the angel said, release me and let me go, wasn't it strange? everybody who has called in tonight. I say this, and I want you to please catch the spirit. We started off with nothing. You know, we came online the first night. I had no idea how many people would turn up. I was scared. I was nervous. Didn't know what to do. Probably didn't even introduce myself. Just went into prayer because I was nervous. God has begun to multiply this prayer line. God has given us favor. God is still giving us favor. I want you to know you've not just come on an ordinary prayer line. God had me release word after word after word after word. Some nights I would just come on and the Spirit of the Lord would take us to another place when it comes to prayer. We've dealt with Nebuchadnezzar. We've dealt with the spirit of Pharaoh. We've dealt with the spirit called Sihon. We've dealt with Ar. We've dealt with all these principalities so far. Some of us had never heard of these principalities before. The key to understanding the word of God is to understand how or what is written in the Genesis. Most of the keys that you're looking for, or most of the, you know, most of the revelation is hidden in the book of Genesis. Because it is where everything starts upon the very foundation. And so I want to challenge you to make a commitment to studying the book. Because let me tell you something. The Bible says that Daniel said he understood by the books. Understanding, you have to grapple with the word. You have to go to a place in the word that you've never been before. Now listen to me. So, you know, my regular callers and those who just joined, if my line cuts out, you know, just stay online and pray. If the line cuts out, just stay online and pray. I'll come back on. You know, whenever, you see, I say to you, whenever you deal with opposition, it is a sign that you're in position. It is not because, you know, it's just happening. It's a sign that you are in position. You are in position for that breakthrough. Thank you all for your support. We haven't seen anything yet. I'm telling you, mark my words. We haven't seen anything yet. The same God who has granted us this favor, the same God who has placed us in this place, he is the same God that will move us from higher to higher to higher. I thank you for being a part of this. Let's lift up our hands slowly. Let's lift up our hands wherever you are. Let us begin to worship. Let us begin to worship and let us begin to invite his presence onto this prayer line. Let us begin to ask him to come and take his rightful position. In the name of Jesus, Father, we thank you. Lord, you are worthy. Lord, you are worthy. Lord, you are worthy. In the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you. Jesus, I worship you. Jesus, I worship you. In the name of Jesus. Thank you for another day. Thank you for another day. Thank you for another day. Thank you for today. Because you are worthy. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, you are worthy. Holy Spirit, you are kind. Holy Spirit, you are worthy. In the name of Jesus. Take your rightful position. Take your rightful position. In the mighty name of Jesus. 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 Father, I thank you for allowing your presence to be part of this conference. Jesus, you are honorable. Jesus, you are magnificent. God, we worship your name. God, we magnify your name. Jesus, you are the reason why we're here. You are the reason why we're alive. I want to thank you for your goodness. I want to thank you for your awesome. God, right now, we ask you to locate this prayer line in the records of heaven. In the records of heaven, locate and find this prayer line in the name of Jesus. Father, we need you. God, we need you. Holy Spirit, we need you. Move and breathe on us in the name of Jesus. Move and begin to breathe on us in the matchless name of Jesus. God, you are honorable. God, you are excellent. God, you are excellent. I thank you for today. I thank you for yesterday. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Jesus. Father, we patiently invite you onto this prayer line. God, this is your doing. This is your set day. This is your hour. This is your time. In the name of Jesus, come and take over. Come and show up. Come in the name of Jesus in your own special way. God, as your people come together, let the realms of the heavens begin to open up. Saturate this prayer line with your glory. God, we know that this is your doing. Because, Father, Lord, if it wasn't because of you, there is no way that, God, those from the state and those in the UK will come together in prayer. Father, it is only because of you that this is possible. Father, because it is possible, we know that nothing that the enemy will generate towards us on this day will work. We know that nothing that the enemy has programmed will work. As a matter of fact, God, we take authority over every agenda, every programming of wickedness, and we break through in Jesus' name. Rise up, Holy Spirit. Lift up yourself right now. Take authority like never before. Show up in the name of Jesus. Father, let the enemy know that this is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. God, we honor you. We love you. We thank you in the name of Jesus. God, be lifted up. Yes, Jesus, show up. Father, hold the prayer line. Hold this prayer line in heaven. Give us unmerited favor. Let the line be held in heaven so that, Father, everybody who comes on this prayer line will always have their deliverance. In the name of Jesus, thank you, we magnify you, and we bless you, God. We lift up your name. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Spirit. In the matchless name of Jesus, Ka'ilivisivu, Sekondivi Avazivazi, Likalava Suku Zikivaza, La Pandika Sabadibi, Lekundivu Sakalavazi, Lavandu Kavazia, Shedive Lakavazu, Evendi Avazi Kavazia, Zivundi Kavazu, Lise Lava Zukava, Shedivu Likivizi, Vandulaba Ziku, Itziki Lavandu Kavazia, Livandu Kavazia, Se Olivi Kava, Se Zewe, Avanti Kozivi, Zava Lokovoziva, Se Ekeve Zikovo, Se Vandivo Zikavazo, Avavazi Kalavatu Zava, Zikando Elevo Zikavazi, Zakando Livi, Sa Zaka, Se Zevo, Jizeve Zaka. You see, we need to learn how to usher in his presence and wait for it to hit. Likovuzi, Zakandi Alava, Siko, Jezeve Vivaza, Elevundi Kavazo, Zakadilaba, Sekundi Ava Zika, Liko Zivandi Laba, O Ziki Zaka, Levevevi, Zikando, Azi Kalavazi, Avanti Kevozevi,
Those that are called
lives, and we pray that God, there will be no, Father God, breakages in the realms of the spirit. Father, we suspend every illegal activity. Father, I come against the spirit that likes to patrol and to listen and to hear what is happening, Father God, with your people. God, if by any chance there are those on this prayer line who are not for us, who just come to listen and to subvert the course of the plan of God for your people, Father, we suspend their connection. Any interference from the regions of the sea, we command it suspended. Any attack from the realms of the occultic, we command it broken. Any atmospheric demon, we suspend your ability to fly. In the name of Jesus, Father, we bless your name and we honor you in Jesus' name. We thank you, God. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, Father, we are now ready to tap into heaven in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. Now, I want you to grab your Bibles, okay? Just going to give you a portion of scripture that we're going to use to let you identify that the reason why you need to pray, the power has been given to you. You are the one that has the ability to pray. Father, anyone having problems logging in, phoning in, Father, we break that resistance. Somebody needs to hear. Somebody needs to know. And so, God, we take authority right now. In the name of Jesus, the lives will stabilize. Nothing will prevent us from going forward. In the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Jesus. Yes, Jesus. We thank you. Genesis 27. Hadovozikava. Itzi avazukavazia. Zaku zi avandi. Hepeli kapaya. Like tata. I'm going to start from verse 34. Genesis 27. And it says, verse 34. When Esau heard the words of his father, he cried with an exceedingly great and bitter cry, and said to his father, "Bless me also, O my father." And he said, "Your brother came with deceit and has taken away your blessing." And Esau said, "Is he not rightly named Jacob? For he has supplanted me these two times. Listen to this. He took away my birthright, and now he has taken away my blessing." And he said, "Have you not reserved a blessing for me?" Then Isaac answered and said to Esau, "Indeed, I have made him your master, Havosiva, and all his brethren I have given to him a servant. With grain and wine I have sustained him. What shall I do for you, my son?" And Esau said to his father, "Have you only one blessing, my father? Bless me also, O my father." And Esau lifted up his voice and wept. Then Isaac his father answered and said to him, "Behold, Kadivo, your dwelling place, your dwelling shall be of the fatness of the earth, and of the dew of heaven from above. By your sword you shall live, and you shall serve your brother." This is the part that gets me. "And it shall come to pass, when you become restless, you shall break his yoke from your neck. Rava ilivikava. Notice that the scripture didn't say, when you become restless, Jesus shall break the yoke of your neck. This is a do-it-yourself night. He said, when you become restless, see, when you get to that place where you look at the circumstances and the situation that you find yourself in, when you get to that place where you see that this is not the life that you were born to live, when you get to that place where you understand that the enemy has strategically placed an injunction and a limit and an embargo on you, and the enemy has caused you to fall back, when you recognize that day that you have been cheated all your life, see, you will get into a position and a posture of prayer, and by the supernatural power that will come upon you, you will break that yoke from your neck. You will break that burden. You will smash that burden into pieces. How does a God who says, that before I formed you in your mother's womb, I knew you? Why would he know you and place a yoke on your life? The yoke that is on your life is an illegal yoke that the enemy has placed upon your life to make you walk and be weary, to make you walk and be tired. Instead of running, you are walking. That is why Solomon woke up one day and decided and caught the revelation. He said, hey, I have seen servants on horses, and I see princes walking barefoot. Listen to me. It is not the desire of the enemy only to dethrone you. It is the desire of the enemy to humiliate you. I felt that. It is not the desire of the enemy just to overthrow you, but it is the desire of the enemy to humiliate you. How does a prince walk bare feet? Tonight, you're going to do it for yourself. Listen to me. Do not be distracted this night. Whenever you see or sense opposition, it is a sign that you're in position. Tonight, we're in position. We are in position to receive the blessings of God. We are in position. The yoke breaker has shown up. The one who breaks yokes has shown up. Leke va zikazazo. Lependi kapalapaya. Alavandivi kavazia. Jize vakuzeve. I sense restlessness on the prayer line. I'm going to go to what God gave me, but I need to deal with this restlessness first. There is a restlessness on somebody which has become a yoke. Lepo likapala, ziva lukaba, le aba likabatia, zikondibi azukava, ezi alavandukazava, lupo likapa, lependika, lu apa likapaya, zi avandukava, zikondivi alavandukava, zivako zi ava, lepo likapalakapati, fata ripa likava, ruku zi avandukava. Jesus. Lava zikavandu kavazi, lava vazu ava lipe lakapatia, rakandu alava, ziku zi ava lipe likapa, rapapa likivu sa, liki vazi kava, limandibu shi vazikovu sava, zizazavazu, rimandu lupu shika, likalava, zikundiva shika, li avazi kuvu zi, zakaliba, sukalaba, zi akava. I come into the prayer line, come into your house spiritually, break the yoke that the enemy has placed upon your life, break the restlessness that the enemy has given you in the name of Jesus. It is not your portion, it is not your portion, that yoke, that weight is too heavy, that burden does not belong to you. In the name of Jesus, by the power of the Holy Ghost, we break that yoke and smash that yoke into pieces. I command that yoke to be broken off your life. In the name of Jesus, every assignment of the wicked one sent to destroy your life, we command it to be broken right now. We command it to be broken right now. In the name of Jesus, Radivazo. Anybody on this prayer line that the enemy has caused you to begin to walk barefoot, anybody that the enemy has caused you to be demoted, every spiritual demotion, every demoted person on this prayer line, leva zi avazukaba, zi avandi abazikibuzia, liku visava, rupundi apalakapaya, zi kalaba likipi, azava lukavazia, jizivundi kava, lipundi kapa, my help is getting stronger now, li avazukabazi, shazavadu kalaba, zi vandu kalaba, zi abandiki, lipundi kapa, li kalaba, uzi kavazia, jizivundi kavazi, limandi dazuku, lipandi kapalapa, remandu kalapasia, jizavandu kuzovu, ilapa ilikipasaya, zu alavandi kaba, zibundi kalaba, ziku ulufu zikalaba. Anyone who has stolen your birthright, anyone who has stolen your birthright, kazifiku zikalava, ziuhu likaba, zi alavandu kivisi visava. Anyone who has jumped, katibu zi avazikaba, in the realms of the spirit, the birth order to take what belongs to you, kavazuki vizi, alamantiku vizi kaba, zivundi kalava, uzike lavanduluvu, zivundi vazikaba, izivu likabadia, limandulubu sikindi lava, zuku di lava. In the name of Jesus, listen, jump quickly to the book of 1 Chronicles chapter 5. I like to always base everything on scripture because that is where we get the keys to prayer from. Okay, we need to follow the instruction that is given to us in the text. And a lot of times, God hides, sometimes, not all the time, but he hides certain revelations in the text. Whenever you see a break, you know, you're reading something, is going one direction, and all of a sudden, you read a sentence or you read a chapter that is contradictory to what you just read before. That's when you need to pay attention to what the Holy Ghost is saying. Take your pens, your papers, your iPads, and make a note of this. Listen to this. Listen to this. 1 Chronicles chapter 5. Hear this. It says, now the sons of Reuben, the firstborn of Israel, which is, he was indeed the firstborn, but because he defiled his father's bed, notice the word, his birthright was given, vakuzi vazia, to the sons of Joseph, the son of Israel, so that the genealogy is not listed according to the birthright. Yet, Ava, Judah, prevailed over his brothers. And from him came a ruler, although the birthright was Joseph. See, read that text, and then the chronicler, it then gives you the names of the sons of Reuben. See, the chronicler could have just gone and just given us the names of the sons of Reuben. But here, the chronicler gave us some spiritual keys and told us that the birth order determines what you have in this life. God just gave me a fax from heaven, and I'm going to release it soon. The birth order determines what you carry in this life. Because by virtue of the fact that you are the firstborn, certain keys and there are certain blessings associated with being a firstborn. But because of the mistake that Reuben made, the Bible says that he was dethroned from being the firstborn spiritually. Listen to this. He was walking planet Earth as the firstborn son of his father. But spiritually, he lost the keys that gave him ownership to the blessings of the firstborn. And those keys was given to the sons of Joseph. But the issue with the sons of Joseph is that they failed to grab hold of the revelation and the insight that they were given.
At
know which part I got to before the line is cut off. But I'm going to go as far back as I can because I was dealing with something called the birthright. And if I'm right, I was dealing with the book of 1 Chronicles chapter 5. And I just showed you how the birthright can be lost. Listen, some of you on this line who are the firstborn, some of you have lost your birthright because of a mistake that you made. There are some spiritual rules, there's some protocol, there are some things that we need to understand. And sometimes just a scream and a shout is not going to be enough. Okay? We need to understand spiritual protocol. We need to understand spiritual regulation. Because the desire of the enemy is to make us feel as though just because we go to church and we shout and scream, that is the end of the issue. That is so not true. Okay? That's what I just proved to you. If Jesus did not follow the rules of this earth, he would have come through Reuben because he would have said, listen, Reuben was indeed the firstborn. But some things that Reuben did disqualified him from being the firstborn. When we deal, lafu isi vikavazia, with what happened with Jacob when he got ready to marry. The Bible says that on the wedding day, he shows up and he finds out that he has been given the wrong one, the wrong person. And so when he inquires of his father-in-law and says to his father-in-law, listen to this, he said, why have you done this to me? Why? Why have you done this to me? How can you do me like this? How can you trick me? How could you do this to me? What did I do to deserve this? This is not what I asked you for. This is not the agreement that we had. This is not what I was looking for. This is not my, you know, this was not my intention. Yes, sir. This is not what I was looking for. I did not work hard for this. Lekoziva. Notice this. I want to show you something. Again, another key. When Jacob went to his father-in-law to ask his father-in-law, why did you do this to me? Listen to what his father-in-law said. Genesis 29. Now, you have to understand that it was not just his father-in-law. This is his angle. See, there are some things that God will reveal to us that we need to pay particular attention to. Notice, listen to this. Listen to this. Listen to what his father-in-law told him. Genesis 29, verse 30. Listen to this. And Laban said, it must not be done so in our country to give the younger before the firstborn. Listen to this. He said, it is not the law of this country for the younger one to prosper before the firstborn. It is not the law of this country. Some of you in the places that you live in, the law dictates. It does not matter how much you love Christ. The law of the land dictates that until the firstborn gets married, you, the one that follows, will never get married. It is the law. That is the spiritual law. That is the rule that has been placed over your house, over the house that you come from. It is the law that the firstborn is the only one or is the first person who has to go through the schooling system and graduate. If they don't, then everybody who follows will not go through school. It is the law of the house that the firstborn is the only one or the first person who can have a business. If they don't prosper in business, you that is following will never prosper. Listen to this. Jacob did not love Leah. Jacob was in love with Rachel. That was the person that he wanted to get married. to the law. Jacob reluctantly had to subscribe to the law. He could not divorce Leah because the law of the land dictated that the firstborn had to get married first. And so in order to get what he really wanted, he had to marry the one that he did not want to marry. Kavu Sikivi. Listen, this morning, by the superior blood of Jesus, by the one who died and rose again on the third day according to the scriptures, you are going to remove yourself from the law of the land. You are going to remove yourself from the lineage that says that it must not be done so. According to the power that you possess, you will command the heavens to rewrite the books just for your favor. Amen. Lift your hands. Father, in the name of Jesus, we take authority right now in the realms of the spirit. Father, we activate the blood of Jesus. God, the blood of Jesus is able to overwrite. It is able to underwrite. It is able to destroy any rule and any regulation which has been placed. Father God, to destroy, God, the advancement of the people of God. Father, today, by the reason of revelation, and Father, by reason of insight, God, we come to change the course of our lives. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for your presence. We thank you for your power. In the matchless name of Jesus, God, right now we command every law which is hanging over the city, over the country that we live in, that seeks to prevent us from advancing into the territory that God, you have made for us. In the name of Jesus, God, we make this decision that God, the advancement of the wicked one, which says that God, because this person in our family did not serve God, did not come through the first time, God, we will be held back. Father, I come to destroy that plan. I come to fight that territory. I come to break that seal that the enemy has placed upon your people, that God, it must not be done so. Well, God, according to your word, you came to set the captives free. According to your word, you came so that the barren, God, will be impregnated. According to your word, you came so that, God, the chains will be broken. According to your word, you came that, God, our spiritual eyes will be opened. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, and by reason of revelation, I stand in authority now to deal with every bloodline curse, every bloodline assignment, every bloodline assignment that is not from heaven. Father, I come to stand in authority to break it in Jesus' name. Let it be broken by reason of the blood. Let it be broken by reason of the authority of Jesus Christ. Let it be broken because the enemy has no power. In the name of Jesus, Zion, I want you to identify one trait in your family bloodline. I want you to identify something that you have seen that just keeps occurring over and over and over again. I want you to look as far back as possible. Get a piece of paper. Get a piece of paper and write that thing down. Likuvuzi avanduvuzi kive. Savandilipu kanata. Zikande lafasukan. Rapalika patataya. Ripundi kava. Zukundi lafa. Likava zikididibu. Ripalakataya. Si avandu kava. Si uzi avadika. Rapalika patupaya. Hey, paluka paya. Palikapaya, Pilikipaya, break in the name of Jesus. Whatever has been written down on paper in the homes of the people of God on this prayer line, by reason of the blood and by reason of the anointing of the yoke breaker, I command you to take that piece of paper and begin to step on it in Jesus' name. Likubuzi Kavadia. The other day, the prophet of God told the king, he said, take this sword and strike it, strike the ground. And the Bible was saying, or the man of God was saying, that as many times as you strike the ground with this sword, that is the many times that you'll be able to destroy or defeat your enemy. Listen, we need to engage in directions. As you write this thing down, take it and begin to strike. on it in Jesus' name. Begin to stamp on the very thing that has become a cycle in your family, and begin to declare that it will no longer prevail over your life. Your children will not repeat that cycle. Your children's children will be free from this cycle. In the name of Jesus, we break that cycle. We destroy that cycle. Let the cycle be broken in Jesus' name. We stamp on that cycle. We stamp on that cycle. We stamp on it in Jesus' name. Whatever you have written down on paper, begin to stamp on it in Jesus' name. Stay on this line. I know it's gone past the hour, but stay on this line. Let us do warfare in the realms of the spirit. And those in London, I know it's gone past 3, but this is one of the prayer watches. This is the hour in the name of Jesus that we will go into the records of heaven and declare that it doesn't matter what the earth's realm has declared. It doesn't matter what has been written in the chronicles of earth, but we will open the chronicles of heaven. We will open the books of heaven, because the books in the realms of the spirit dictate what goes on upon this earth. So right now we declare and we release in the name of Jesus. Rapandi kapala, lepe katalava, zu alavandi kibosia, Jesu vutima. I said, stamp on what you have written. Stamp on it in Jesus' name. Put your foot on that thing that the enemy has caused to be a stronghold. In the name of Jesus, we break the neck of this stronghold. We break the neck of this stronghold. Let the neck of this stronghold be broken. Be broken in Jesus' name. Be broken in Jesus' name. Le kalaba silavantu kalavazika le kalabalika le mandu. In the name of Jesus, Holy Ghost, send the fire of God. Command the fire of God to burn it down right now in the stronghold of your family. Let it be broken in Jesus' name. Let this stronghold be broken. Let the fight that was stolen from you in the name of Jesus, let it return to you right now a thousandfold. Let it return to you right now in Jesus' name. Every key that belongs to you according to your birth order, I release it into your life right now. I release it into your hands. Open your hands right now wherever you are.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Open your hands
in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Open your hands wherever you are. Lord, I present every hand point to you. Father, you know every fiber of our being. God, in the realms of the spirit, I want you to look into the palm of everybody, Jesus. Some hands, God, are empty because the enemy has stolen what rightfully belongs to them. Father, some hands are supposed to have wedding rings on them, according to the record of heaven. Father, some hands are supposed to have business keys, successful business keys. Father, some of these hands are supposed to prosper, but the enemy has placed a yoke upon these hands. Some of these hands, God, are in chains, bondages, Father, all manner of things are being represented by the lifting up of the hands of your children. God, according to the record of heaven, the same angel who showed up and fought and wrestled with Jacob and would not let go, or Jacob would not let go, but God, the same angel who made us aware that there is a record in heaven that keeps the names of every child of God. God, your word also said that God, they overcame by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. God, let the testimony of the righteous on this prayer line be that God, today is the day that you change their fingerprints. God, whatever is attached to their hands that is foreign, God, every slavery spirit, every spirit of oppression, Father, as you look into every hand, keep your hands open. Father, keep those hands opened up. Wherever you are, open up your hands and follow the direction of the Holy Ghost. God, whoever is carrying a guilty verdict, irrespective of what the enemy wants to do with them, God, they are in your hands. Because, Father, your word says that, God, we are engraved in the palm of your hands. And, Father, nothing that is engraved in the palm of your hands, God, is evil. So, God, right now, every weight, God, Kiva, Izakava, Lipo, Kipili, Pipaya, Aparika, Patipi, Lupe, Kapa, Ikalapantu, Kalapati, Kipi, Skatalapa, Lord, Kalivo, Izikivo, Jazaza, Divi. Some of you will begin to feel your hands moving. Don't be scared. Kadi alava. Your hands will begin to shake. Ka likama pasi kapaya. Ilipe kapu la papa lipala pataya. Ilapandi kalapa suke lipe. Alapandi kepelepo. Skate lapandi kalapa. Le kalapa kilapatu. Rapandi kalapatua. Seva likabazia. Jesus. Kalovo zikelebu. Manti kalaba. The yoke breaker is breaking that bond. Is breaking that bondi. Uli vizikebu. Repandi kalapaya. Zikundi lakavazia. Shazava. Uli pelikapa. Rupundi kepe. Palikataya. Zikundi lize. Zikandi lavandukava. Ziku lapalika. Ili madolubu zikandilizi zakundi lakalapa ilapandu kalapa ziku lipi. In the name of Jesus, let it be broken. Let it be broken. Let it be broken. Let it be broken. Kadzuvu zivandi kalava ziku ziki lavazi kavazia. In the name of Jesus, Father, let it be broken. Jesus, let it be broken. Holy Ghost, let it be broken. I break it in Jesus' name. I break that spirit in Jesus' name. I take it off your hands. Whoever came into contact with your hands and made an illegal spiritual agreement, let that power be broken. Let that agreement be broken by reason of the blood. Kadovu ziki vizia. Kalavandu kalaba. Ziku likalavaziu. Jazavandi kaba. Ziku dil. Zakandilivi. Kava Zukava. Let that power be broken. Let that power be broken. Zako Elebi. Azavanduvu. Zika. Lekevo Zikevi. Zahava Zikavazua. Alavandi Kivu. Jezevozia. Let that power be broken right now. I break that power. Open your hands. Liku Razia. Whoever has taken your ring, your wedding ring, that's what I mean. Kazazuka Lavazia. Ilipu Kiti Safa. La Pandi Kalapa. We command that hand that came into contact with you to break you, to take you away from your destiny, which is your marriage. I command that hand, I command that invincible even hand, evil hand, to be broken off of you right now. In the name of Jesus, Likuvu, Likivu Zikava, Itzi Kavazia, Zavandivu, Zikilipu, Sakandilaba, Zuku, Livendika, Zivandi Lobo, Zivondi Lava Zava, Liku Livazi, Jazavandi Lava, Zuvu Lika, Zekundi Lava. I am breaking Zaku, Zikandi Lobo, Ja Zeku, Lipa, Likivu Zika Vazia. I am breaking it in Jesus' name. Zakadi Lava, Zekundi Lava Zia. I break whatever the enemy has placed in your hands, that is not God. Let it be broken in Jesus' name. Lava Zuketevo, Zavanti Kalava, Zuvo Liba, Likivu Zia, Je Avaziko Develeve, Otsita Lavandi Kava. Listen to me. Listen to me. It is no coincidence, you know, when God gives me some scriptures to pray, I'm trying to figure out what direction is God leading us to. Whenever the enemy, whenever the law, you know, the system of the world comes to arrest you, note that they don't place the chains on your head. You don't place the chains on your eyes, mm-hmm. on your ears, or your mouth. They place the chains on your hands. I just came from heaven. No. Listen to me. The enemy or the world understands the power that's in your hands. No. As we were praying, the scripture that came to me was the very question, listen to this, that God asked Moses in the book of Exodus chapter 4, verse 2. A simple scripture. Listen, the first verse says, then Moses answered and said, but suppose they will not believe me or listen to my voice. Suppose they say the Lord has not appeared to you. So the Lord said to him, listen to this. When Moses was procrastinating or was nervous about the assignment that God was giving him, was asking God questions, and listen, these people, suppose they start asking me, oh man of Christians. Notice that God never gave him an answer. What God said to him was simple. God said to him, What is that in your hand? Kadoluvu zikevizia. Alavandikovu zeku. Listen, we are pushing the rod. The weight, the illegal object that the enemy has placed in your hands that you don't know of, that is causing you to be a failure. Some of you are walking around with invincible things, invincible objects in your hands, and because you are holding on to it, it is impossible for you to open up to receive what heaven has for you. That's why I say, open up your hands. We're going in a totally different direction tonight. Because I need to break what your hands is holding on to that is not God. I need to break what you're holding on to that is not God. See, some of you are holding on to dead relationships. Some of you are holding on to debt partnerships, and as long as you hold on to it, you will never be able to let go to receive what God has for you. See, Lot's wife, God delivered. Tonight is on. Hey, Jesus. Kalava. Lot's wife was holding on to the past, and she will eventually make the mistake of turning around, and she will be turned into a pillar of salt. God delivered. Zava likavazua. Alapandike pelikipaya. Simandiku. Alafasika palapaya. Lipandikalava. So, Kalavazikivi, God is on this prayer line. That's one thing I know for certain. God is on this prayer line, breaking the yokes, breaking the burdens that have been placed upon the lives of people. God is on this prayer line, and the Holy Ghost is on an assignment to break the yokes of your life. Ka di avaduvi. Ka di avaduvi. Ka di avadivi, za zakalava, zaka lipi, ala patuka palipaya, lipe kapa, open your hands, lipe kalapasikaya. Some of you will begin to sense like something is being lifted off your hands. Likalava, zike lapandikapaya. Father, the chains that the enemy has placed upon the lives of your people, kaduvu zikaba. Listen. Something, my God, the revelation that God is giving us tonight is different. Listen, something was programmed by heaven to be the one that will destroy the Philistines. That was the mandate that heaven had decreed for something. Samson was such a strong man. Even when he was on the verge of giving his power away, he would put some chains on his hands and he would break free. That's the power that Samson possessed. Samson was called by God to break the children of Israel out of the captivity, out of the stronghold of the Philistines, and we dealt with that last week. We will go there again. There was something the Holy Ghost gave me, but we've just gone in a totally different direction. But I know during the week we're going to go back to that. But somebody needed to hear what I'm saying tonight. Listen to this. Samson was a strong man, powerful man, a man sanctioned by God to be the one who will break his people free. That was the assignment that was given to Samson. Samson had enough power. Kadilevozikalava Azi Kavaziva Lupo Dilapasia. When Delilah was able to get through to Samson and give him over to the Philistine, the Bible says in the book of Judges chapter 16, it says, then the Philistines took him and put out his eyes and brought him down to Gaza. They bound him with bronze fetters, and he became a grinder in the prison. Somebody whose hands were supposed to bring down the enemy, he was now a grinder in the prison. Listen to me. There is somebody on this prayer line that the enemy has now made you a grinder in the realms of the spirit. You are now grinding in prison. I break you out of that prison right now. Open your hands. I break you out of that prison. I smash that chain. I smash that chain. I smash those bondages that the enemy has placed over you. I break it off you right now. Kadihu, your name is Samson, but you are in prison. Kadulupo kipaya. Lepondi kepe. Lapa kutalapatia. Stay on this line. We are breaking the chains. We are breaking the limit that the enemy has placed upon you. as a matter of fact, everybody on planet Earth, no two fingerprints are the same. No two fingerprints are the same. That is why sometimes when they catch criminals or to identify you, they will ask you to put your thumb and your four fingers on an identity document, because your fingerprints determine who you are. If the enemy can take your hands, if the enemy can get a hold of your fingerprint, then your enemy can bind you and keep you in bondage so that you will never reach the place of your destiny or calling. But tonight, this morning, by the superior authority and by revelation, by the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the one who died and rose again, the one who came to die to save us, we implore the sword of the Lord. In the name of Jesus, let this bondage be broken. Let this bondage be broken. Any hand that is grinding, any hand that is grinding, any hand that is grinding, I command that grinding to be broken. I command the spirit of that grinding to be broken. You will not grind anymore. You will not clean anymore. In the name of Jesus, we remove your hands from the prisons. We command your hands to be free. Likalabandi kipaya. Solebe kava. Zizavadulu fusia. I'm going to bring somebody home right now. Chikilebu zia. Zakandulaba. Elebu kilapandia. Zikundilivi. Azakalaba. Suku likava. Zikalavandi. Alapandi kalaba. Suku likivizia. Zazavadulaba zi. Lipandulava zi. Kava zika. Let this truth be broken through. Kava sukilipi. Alapandi kipilipaya. I enter into every prison. Every prison where a child of God has been hidden. Kaduva zikalava. Ilipendi kapala. Lapali kalapandi. Vakuziva. Leka vaziko livazia. Lekandi laba. Suku. We will be victorious. We will prevail. As the children of God, we will prosper. Likalaba, 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 dilabaya. Jesus, we break it. Jesus, we break it. Father, I break it. I break that stronghold. I break that chain. Let it be broken off your life. Let it be broken off your hands. Anything that you lay your hands to, I command it to prosper. Hadilivizaya. Lekuzivizikulava. Zimandulovuzikivi. In the matchless name of Jesus, I bring you home in the realms of the spirit. Your hands will not wander. Your hands will not just be moving around doing nothing. Your hands will be victorious. In the name of Jesus Christ, the one who died and rose again. Let the people of God be victorious this hour. Jesus, you are victorious. Jesus, you are powerful. Jesus, you are awesome. Kandivu, Kilavazo Kulovu. Receive your breakthrough. Receive your breakthrough. Receive your breakthrough. Hey, Vaso Kudovu. Likivuzia. Zikin Delevi. Kuzivi. Ah, Vaso. Vasikivu. Zikon Delevi. Kazovu. Levu. Zikalava. Zukun Delevi. Zakutivu. Javan Delevi, Zakab, Levu, Zikalava, Sukuliva, Zike, Luvu, Zikava, Sukuliva Zia, Zikundiva, Zikundilevi, Zakutiva, Zikulava. Let it be broken. Let it be broken. Let it be broken. Let it be broken. in the name of Jesus, we smash it into
in
in your hands to suspend every illegal activity. I place power in your hands to smash into pieces every wall that has been lifted up over your life. Hadirobo, Savandibilipi, Fako Lavasia, Leke Dodobo, Leke Dodobo Dibe, Hadolobo, Leko Diva, Seolepe, Sapo Lapaliapa. Somebody, you have just enlarged your office. You have just enlarged your business. Hadilivusia, Lepotikalapa, Sekontini Visaya. Somebody has just added years, extra years to your life. Lepotipe, Padipali Palapaya, Lepotikapa, Sekontini V, Sekalava. Zekandelevu ziava alabandika paya ze okolivi alapatika lapa zeko likalava lependika pa break over your life zemandolobo lepe kachalava zekutilava zekundilivi lekandevu zekundilivi zako tilava Sekundi lava, ebundi kalaba, seolobundi, kadelebe, azakandelebe, savandelebe, kadolovo, zakandelebe, Jesus, Jesus, hey, vazivu, zavaya, push one more time, lepedi kapa, lepedi palapaya, alapandula pa, zepali kalaba, epepe, let it be broken. Kavazi kavaya. Jesus. Le kandolobo. Zako zikalaba. Zevo lebe dikaba. Zokondelebe. Zakaleva. Zokondiva. Zekandilobo zia. Lebe lipalapaya. Zazavadikava. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Father, grant the wishes of your people. God, I have stood on your name, and I have declared that, God, the chains over their hands is broken. God, every spirit of the Philistines, which came to place bondages on their hands, I come to break it, because the yoke breaker is in town. Let it be smashed to pieces. God, believe me. God, do you. Seek and do Ele pekila paya, ele peka pa dipo, alakapula kapaya, zekundi levi, zazavatu kabalia, leko livazia, alavandu kalava, zeko leve zika vazia, zezevuzi vazia, alavandu kava. Nobody will be left behind on this prayer line. You will get your breakthrough. Kati levi. Alavandolovo. Jesus, we are going. We are moving. Kadivizaya. Jesuvu divizia. Leve sukava. Zimandilipikava. Uchikalavazia. Zikendilivizia. Zukundiva. Anybody that the enemy has placed leprosy on your hands, spiritual leprosy. Kadivu. Zikundivi. Savandi kavaya, zukundelevi, savandulugu, kadelevezia. I break that leprosy of your hands. Kandelevezia, zubativu, zeku leteli kapaya, apandu kapa, apandu kapa, apandu kapa, pelepe papa lapa. Break.
In the name of Jesus.
Hey, Jesus. I feel the Holy Ghost. Kadilovu. Eze kalava zikaya. Jelovu zika. Zekandilava zia. Zekundilava. Leko zikalava. Jesus, this is your will. Jesus, this is your plan. Jesus, this is your desire. Kandilovu zia. Father, come restless. And this restlessness has caused us on this day to break the yoke of our lives. Apandu kapaya. Jesus. Leko diva. Zikundelevi. Ah, Jesus Christ, Lord. Jesus Katuvu. Zekadivazuyu. Lekevesia. Kuzudulubu. Lepelipalapa. Ependikupa. Ependikupa. Lekeziva. Zukundilava. Jesus. Keep your people. Lepu lapaya. Zekundelevi. Zavazia. Ekatava. Ah, Jesus Christ. We will not be left out. We will not be left out. We will not fail. In the name of Jesus. Handevezia. Jesus. Lekedevu. Zekundevi. Avazika vazia. Elebundikevi. Zakadila vazie. Lekudiva. Zemandelebu. Zeku lepelika. Zekudilava. Eh, Jesus. Zakundilava. Eh, Jesus. Lekudiva. Zekundilava. Lepo likapaya. Lependikapa. In the name of Jesus. Lukutilava. Hey Jesus. Lukulivazia. In the name of Jesus. Kaduvuzia. Zekundilevi. Jesus, do it, God. Jesus, do it, God. Lekudilevi. Hey, Kaduvu, receive that impartation. Kaduvu. Let your hands be free right now. Let your hands be free. Odi apalikapaya. Every advantage that was taken from your hands, I command that advantage to be given back to you. In the name of Jesus. Lekalava. Zukutivazaya. Lekalavazu. Apandila patua. Palika patua. Palika patua. Palika patua. Palika patua. Palika pa apatua kapa. Lepedia. Yes, Lord, we lift up your name and we glorify you, Jesus. Kanduvu. Zekutivazia. Lefandulubu. Katilivizia. Jesus, we lift up your glorious name. In the name of Jesus, work your work upon the lives of your people. God, I don't feel that you are ready to let your people go. Le kutivazia, le kadava. Receive what you're looking for right now. Receive it in Jesus' name. Le apatilapa. Glorify God. Lift your hands up. Let the heavens see that there are no longer chains on your hands. We have broken the chains. We have broken the limits. Le busikava alafatukavatia. Fatipa patepepepepa. Jesus. Yes, Lord. Le apatia. Samandikava. Le po pilapa. Hey. Zakandulubu. Etsekutiba. Zemande. Fakiva. He's here now. Kadelebu. He's getting ready to release us. Kadubu. Zikandulubu. Yes, Lord. Hey. Kadilava. Zekundilava. Zekulubu. Lepelikapaya. Apapalikapa. Zukundilevi. Levendikavasaya. Zekundilevi. Zakandulubu. Zekedevilavazia. Zevadivuza. Zakandilevi. Hey, Jesus. Kadivu. Zekudilevi. Zevudilaba. Zekudilevizia. Leva vaka, leva vaka, leva vaka, leva vaka, leva vaka. We take authority. Vaka, lepa likapa, likalapa, likalapa, likapa, lipapa, likapa, likapa, palapaya, pilepapa, papa lipapa, patepo, palikipa, lipandepe, palipatapaya, pileposa palapaya, hepalapa, hepalipikapaya, zikipolupaya, pilikipa. Patopo, Pilipe, Pakata, Pilipe, Kapa, Pilapatopo, Papa, Palapa, Lipipe, Lapapa, keep palapataya, pande pokapa, likapatuku, leke palapatia, fakatuka pelepi. In the name of Jehovah, Jesus.
Yes, Father. Thank you, Father.
Yes, Lord. We're almost there. Hey, Zion, we're almost there. Zekuliva, Zikadava. We're almost there, people. Kadilava. We're almost there. Kadivizaya. Zekulivedibasia. I have changed your fingerprints. I have changed your fingerprints. You are no longer the person that you was 2 hours ago. Le Kadavazia. Receive that impartation. Receive that revelation. Your hands are your authority right now. You are now in the position of authority. Kadilipizaba. Epe Kalapatia. Le Pandi Kalapa. Ulupudikapa. Zegundilivi. Za alavazua. Talikalapa. Le katalava. Jesus. So shall it be. It is so. The Bible says when the man of God was travailing, wanting for rain to come, his servant will come back one last time and will say to him, I see a cloud, and the cloud resembled, or it was the size of a man's hand. Somebody, I see your hand rising up. Kadilipoli palapaya. Hey, sapo, pilapa, epetilapantopo, lepe kilapaya, sokolifata. I see a cloud. Televizia, lepe likapa, sokolipaya. Even though you are guilty, when they take your fingerprints and they want to match it to the scene of the crime, your fingerprints will be different to what they took from the crime scene. Alapandikapaya. Break in Jesus' name. Kutifusia. Jesus. Kantilifusikapa. There is enough power on this prayer line. Epe kilapaya. Father, we thank you.
Thank you, Father.
Today, tonight, has been a glorious night. Nothing will take away what you have done. Father, now, the records of heaven which records prayer, the book where prayers are written in, I want the record of this prayer to be placed before you. And I want it to be played back every day, every night, every minute, every second. Let it be in your ears and your nostrils. God, the names of everybody that is on this prayer line, you know. Father, let their names also be before you. Because, Father, I am demanding their unconditional release. No territorial satanic agendas will prevail over their hands. Their hands now have the advantage. In the name of Jesus, Father, visit them. Bless them. Let their households be blessed. Never let them be lacked in their homes. In the name of Jesus, Father, I lift up my hands as a sign of surrender.
Yes.
To say that God, let this prayer line be your line.
Yes.
Let this be the line that is known as the yoke breaking line.
Yes, Father.
Hatili Vizaya. Alapandi Kupu. Epe Dikapaya. Let the people all over the world know that there is power in the name of Jesus. And distance is no barrier.
Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father.
So let it be, God. In Jesus' name. Father, I thank you. I honor you. I bless your name. God, you said, will you not do a new thing? And will it not spring forth? God, look at what you are doing. not just in my life, but God, in the lives of everybody on this prayer line. Who can take somebody from nowhere in a matter of days and bring them to this place? Father, we already look different to what we looked like last week. Father, we are walking different. We are more confident. Hey, we are different because of the confidence that we have in prayer. Father, we worship and we adore you. We bless your name. Kativi, Zeku Diva, Zizantili Vizaya. Jesus. Yes, Lord. Shout. Give God some praise. I know it sounds crazy. Kavuzi Kavazia. Jesus, we bless your name. In the name of Jesus. Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you for allowing me to be a voice. God, let your name be lifted up. In Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. Father, we honor you. In Jesus' name. Thank you once again for bringing us together. In Jesus' name. Amen. Now listen to me. Please don't just stay on the line for a couple of minutes. Just one or two things that I want to share with you. I normally give some announcements, you know, just give you an update of what's going on. But because, you know, I was, you know, the line was messing up, I couldn't do that to come straight into it. Listen to me. I was able, I think I emailed out, you know, maybe one or two emails. You know, you should have, you know, notes, I think for the 12th and the 13th. You know, and there's going to be, I think, two or three more that we're going to send out, you know, if possible, tonight, you know, you guys, America, in America, or early morning here. So I'm going to send out those notes, okay, so that, you know, you will be able to have all the notes so far, the ones that we weren't able to send out. And, you know, I just want to thank, you know, there's a lady, you know, that's, you know, just contacted and said, Albert, you know, I don't mind typing it, and she's been doing a fantastic job. You listen. Listen, see, obedience is very important. Okay, let me share something with you. You know, some of you have seen, you know, I've just been putting one or two pictures up there. You know, there was a friend of mine who came to take some pictures, you know, of me, because I told you, we're getting better, you know, and, you know, he took some, you know, had a photo shoot. And, you know, he's a white guy, you know, he took the pictures. And then he took one picture, you know, and then he said to me, you know, he said to me that, hey, Albert, look. You know, he said, Albert, look, you know, I can see, you know, this was his words. He said, Albert, I can see your energy. I kid you not. Some of my friends have seen it. When he took the picture, it's almost like he saw like a transparent hand. I don't know how to describe it. He saw a transparent hand, you know, on top of my hand, you know. He saw a transparent hand. He said, Albert, this is not normal. You know, I sent it to Prophet Khan this morning. I said, Prophet, look at what the photographer picked up. And as he was doing, he was telling me to just talk about Jesus. You know, so I was talking about Jesus, and, you know, my body would start jerking, my body would start moving, you know. And it's almost like during the course of that, because those things happen in a split second, he was able to capture it. Listen to me. God is doing something fantastic on this prayer line. I don't want it to be a dropout. When God speaks, you know, another young lady contacted me and said, you know, when you said a thing about you want to build that prayer center, you know, I think one time I just said this. Yeah, I'm beginning to, you know, one thing I've learned from Prophet Khan is to be bold. When God says something, you don't question it, you just put it out there. Because listen, God will give me the idea, right, or you know, the plan or whatever, and then God will give you, on the other side, the provision to make what God has given me come to pass. That's how God works most of the time. So we need to catch it. So, you know, people have been messaging me saying, okay, Albert, you know, I don't know what the plan is, but, you know, one lady contacted me, you know, she's been in the teaching, you know, she's been in education for a long time. So obviously she has experience. See, I don't know how to do this thing. I just heard it and I just put it out there. And I know there's people that God will assign to come and be a part of this. Listen, what we're building and what we're trying to do is not for any, you know, it's for the glory of God, and it's for your children and your children's children. Anytime they're ready, you know, there's places, and you know, in England here we have places that you can go for retreat. See, that generation of old, if they were selfish, we wouldn't have these places to go to now and pray in the crazy time that we're living in. So we need to learn to become selfless. I keep saying this. We're too selfish now in the body of Christ. All we think of is me, me, me. Let's be selfless, okay? And think of a generation yet unborn. Even this generation, look at the craziness that they're dealing with. And sometimes all they need is for, you know, to be taken out of the current environment that they're in and placed in another environment. And sometimes see how people the same age as them, you know, don't have the things they have and take for granted, you know, that, you know, they take for granted what they have in America, even in the UK. So if God, you know, if God allows us to build this facility, we take them over there, they will see life, or, you know, they will pick up a, you know, spirit of prayer. By the time they come back to the stage, you will not recognize them. So that's the vision that God has given. I'm just throwing it out there. Okay, whoever is on this prayer line, that, you know, anything, you know, whatever you think can help, you know, don't discount. If God tells you, just email, say, listen, this is what I think, you know, and let's talk. I don't know. I'm just like you. I don't know. I'm learning as we go along. Okay, the one thing I know is, you know, I can pray a little bit, but, you know, most of the time, you know, when God tells me something, I just put it out there. And I keep saying this again. Listen, there's enough people on this prayer line, you know, who come on to pray. And I believe I'm very supportive of what is happening. But my question to you is, listen, things I talk about, rules, regulations, it goes hand in hand. You know, you come and you pray, you put a seed on the ground as a as a reminder to God, as a memorial. Say, God, listen, I prayed, but I also sowed a seed. So God, by virtue of the fact that I prayed and sown a seed, you have to remember me.
Jesus.
You know, there's still people, you know, there's some key people who I keep seeing their names, you know, they've been sowing. I tell you, every morning I wake up, say, God, I don't want nobody to sow into this prayer line and be broke. So I always pray for them. I say, God, they have caught the vision. They can see what is happening. So God, do not forget them. Listen, I said, it doesn't matter, you know, whatever amount. I don't put a limit. Because God knows. See, from that little that you put in, God knows where it's coming from. So tonight, you know, obviously this is the challenge. I don't want to be talking about all the time. So listen, whatever. Listen, I started this thing. I had no idea what was going to happen. Started this prayer call the first night. I was nervous. I was scared. Never done it on my own before. Didn't even know if we could carry on for the rest of, you know, for the rest of the week. And every single night, God just kept on blowing my mind that we're sitting here today. You know, I told you, you know, some of you, you know, Facebook, you know, I was out preaching. It was so powerful. It was so powerful, you know, that now they're looking for me to come back for two nights. You know, this is what God is doing. They're looking for me to come back two nights because God is doing a new thing. And I'm walking, you know, I spoke to Prophet Khan earlier. I said, Prophet, you know, one thing I can say is I've definitely got an impartation from you, because question that I'll ask him and he'll try to explain certain things to me. I'm like, people, I don't get it. I don't see how you do this. I don't get it. But, you know, Prophet would just say to me, Albert, well, you know, this is what I do. One thing about him, God tells himself, he doesn't question. He just goes ahead and says it before his rational mind would get hold of it. And I was in this church ministry and I was laying hands on certain people. And afterwards, I was being told that this person that you prayed for XYZ, this person is XYZ. And I just know that was because that's because I'm serving the man of God. Listen, some of you need to understand, sometimes you need to put down your dream and your vision for a season to serve a man or woman of God. God will test you. That's what keeps saying to this rule. We cannot break certain rules and regulations that God has put in place. Even God himself has to follow it. So we also have to abide by the rules. Amen? And so please, I keep saying, be a supporter. Put your money where your prayer is. You believe in this prayer line? There's so many other prayer lines that you can go on to, but you are always here every night. Why don't you sow into this prayer line? Just show your support. You know, everything that is being given is accounted for. I'm putting things in place. You know, every single day I'm busy. I'm meeting people, friends, who see on Facebook what's happening. They're like, Albert, what's going on? I need to sit down with you and talk to you so that you can put things. I promise you, I say this to everybody. I say, listen, one thing Albert is not going to do is say, I'm not going to hell for nobody. Money has never been my issue. So every seed that has been sown is still sitting there. Not a single penny has been touched. Because listen, I'm scared of God. I ain't going to hell. And so I'm asking you, be a supporter. Okay? If you haven't got the emails, you know, the notes, just inbox me on prayermantle3@gmail.com and you'll be added to, you know, the mailing list. Okay? prayermantle3@gmail.com and it's prayermantle3@gmail.com. Send an email and we just send it out. Thank you for being a support, for supporting this prayer line, not just by coming on to pray, but saying, Albert, I can do this. You know, the lady who's been typing, she's just been fantastic. She just comes and, you know, Albert, she goes online, listens to it, and then types it out. And that's how everybody's been able to receive. So I want to thank God for every supporter, everyone who has become a partner in a way to what God is doing. God bless you. We're getting better. We're getting bigger. You know, you see some of the missing. I put on the number on Facebook. I think I even left out the zero. See, you know, that's just telling you, this is God. This is God. You know, this is not man. This is what God is doing. And we need to appreciate that God will pick up somebody from nowhere. You know, I always say this, you know what I mean? You know, I'm not from the States. You know, I'm born in Ghana, raised in the UK. You know, but God just has a way of working. God will do what he wants to do. And somebody listening on this prayer line, don't count yourself out. You'll be surprised by where God will put you the next day. You'll be surprised in the next 72 hours how your life will just turn around. If you just keep your eyes on God. Bible says many are called, but few are chosen. Make yourself the person that will be chosen, not called, but chosen. Let God be pleased with your life. I want to thank you for staying this long with me. I think this is probably the longest we've stayed on. I want to thank you. I want to appreciate you. God keeps you. Remember, always have your notepads and your pens with you, because God will speak to you in dreams and in visions. God will show you some of what's on your hands that needs to be broken off still. God will bring us back tomorrow. Please pray that this prayer line, you know, the phone line holds, because, you know, sometimes I have problems, you know, calling in myself. But I'm, you know, before I'll panic, but I'm learning not to panic. I just, you know, keep my cool. And, you know, I just call him because I know anytime, you know, that happens, I know God is getting ready to do something awesome. Listen, stay prayerful. Stay prayerful. Stay focused. I will meet you again the same time tomorrow. And tomorrow we will go higher, because that's all we're doing. We just keep going higher. This prayer line just keeps going higher. Thank you. Remember to sow. In Jesus' name. I love you.